Subprime, it's back. Does that word make you shudder? Well, it should, because subprime lending was the cause of the housing crisis in 2007. So what is subprime? Subprime is a loan for borrowers with questionable credit. People with good credit get the best rate, the prime rate. People with lousy credit or a spotty job records or low income, basically risky bets for paying back money, they get what are called subprime rates. That means really high interest rates. So a prime borrower might get, say, 4.5% mortgage today. A subprime borrower, we're talking about like 10%. Subprime loans are still out there, but they're mostly from smaller lenders. But even some big banks are slowly dipping their toes back into the subprime game, but very cautiously, because what happened at the bubble was really ridiculous. Some of these adjustable rate mortgages had interest rates that doubled, tripled, quadrupled. There were loans that didn't require that you had to pay them back. When that bubble burst, it was very dangerous. When home prices started falling, people couldn't sell their houses and they couldn't pay the mortgages. Foreclosures skyrocketed, and a lot of those subprime loans, they had been repackaged. They were sold as investments, and the value of those investments tanked, and that damaged the U.S. economy. Now, since then, lending rules have gotten much tighter. That's good. It protects people from getting sucked into loans they can't afford, but it also shuts people out of the housing market. First-time home buyers in 2013 was just 29% of the market. Usually, it's more like 40%. Let's face it, not everyone who wants to buy a home has perfect credit, and there is starting to be a market again for lenders who want to cater to this group and subprime borrowers who want to get into the housing market. Subprime is coming back, just a little bit smarter than before, we hope.